Hello, my name is Sargam Mehra. Welcome to my Life page. Today we are going to talk about teaching and researching in communication. But before we do that, let me introduce myself. I graduated in history. I'm a person from the social sciences and humanities background. I did my schooling from scholars on Dehradun. I did my bachelor's in history from Lady Sri Ram College, the University of Delhi. Thereon, I did an MA, a master's in history from IGNO, again in Delhi. Another master's that I did was in communication from Doon University, Delhi. Currently, I'm a research fellow. I'm pursuing my PhD, my doctoral research from Doon University, Delhi. I have worked as a journalist, as a reporter in the United News of India, which is a Delhi-based news agency. So when you talk about communication, you can talk about mass communication, which is what journalists and reporters and people in the media industry do. So when we are talking about research in communication, we essentially cover all these aspects. And as a researcher, teaching is another line which is open for you in this field. The first thing is that you need to have a very basic knowledge of journalism. That does not mean that you have to write reports or press release. But journalism ka basic knowledge means that you should have a knack for news, for things that you think are going to make news, for things that are going around you. You need to have a very keen eye for that and a very basic knowledge of how to put these things together in one piece of writing or one piece of photography or videography that you are doing. The basic skill that you will need is that you must be a very patient and a very good listener. जब तक आप सुनते नहीं हैं, तब तक आप communicate भी नहीं कर सकते हैं. Our communication is a constant cycle of sending and receiving. So unless you receive a message well, you can definitely not send your messages well. So you need to be a very good listener. Now the biggest positive is that you are open to a whole new world of learning. You get to learn a lot. That also keeps your mind ticking, that keeps you mentally very active, and that keeps your knowledge updated. The biggest challenge that you are facing is facing technology. Because as researchers in communication especially, we need to be very updated with what's the latest software, what's the latest phone, what is the latest technological progress that's going on in the country. And often we tend to overuse technology while teaching. So I believe personally that we should refrain from doing that. We should not become dependent on any kind of technology anyhow. Because technology kabhi kabhi bahut flimsy medium ho jata hai. Agar aapka laptop kharab ho gaya to aapki padhai nahi ho rahi hai. It should not be, that piece should not be there. So that is a very big challenge that we face. We normally start our day by reading as many newspapers and news as much as we can lay our hands on. So that includes definitely English newspapers and Hindi and regional newspapers as well. We access news through online portals also because they are updated more regularly. Then we go to college, have our classes, and that's about 6 to 8 hours of direct contact with students. They come up to us with various problems which are related to their subject, which are related to their careers. So a good amount of seven hours, like that's like almost one third of your day, you are spending inside an academic campus where you meet different teachers, you meet different students, you are constantly in an environment of learning. Once we are done with our classes, we go back to our office and we get back to writing our research. Thesis, research papers, because we get them, normally we get them published in journals, present them in seminars, whatever. So, hum log iske liye bahut padhai karte hain aur research mein bahut important hai ki ek time pe aap aapka jo thought process hai wo ek flow mein chal rahe. It should not be very scattered. So, flow mein lane ke liye usko thoda sa time lagta hai. So, we spend minimum of 3 hours in streamlining our thought process and reading journals, writing whatever we want to, and we end our day again by watching news, by keeping ourselves extremely updated with the current affairs and what is happening around the world. I hope I was able to give you a balanced view on what teaching and researching in communication is. Thank you.